Hey everyone, so today we are at my house, so I took some ingredients with me, and I'm just gonna make a coffee quickly. That's for me and John. And so today we're gonna make a rice pudding. So it seems to be simple, but I love to share my recipe with you. Do you like it strong, the coffee, John?
Because it comes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, that won't be long. So, what we need to start with, a recipe book. So, we're gonna use some pudding rice. So it's like a round rice. We're gonna use 75 grams of it. We're just gonna make a little batch. I'm not sure about that scale. Might go in a minute. The battery. That's too much. 75, yeah? It's very precise. Into a pan. And then some whole milk. Very important because it's much richer. Look at this one. It even has cream on top. This is a proper Devon milk. How many? 600 grams. Maybe I should weigh it up. So I've just put 40 grams. So we need 600, yeah? That will be it. Exactly. Oh, my knife. That's a good start. And then some sugar. So, sugar, we're gonna put 75 grams as well. That's the sugar from the kitchen. We decided to do the video here because it's much warmer. Bloody freezing in my kitchen. 75 I said. 77, that will do. Okay. So, it's all together. We're just gonna stir it. So we have the rice, the sugar, and the whole milk. And here, I love to put a few peels of orange. Because I'm gonna flavor it with orange and cinnamon. Just one like that. Two. That should do. Be strong enough. And at the end, once it's ready, we're gonna put some cinnamon, little bit. A cinnamon stick would have been nice right now, but I think I don't have. So, yeah, I just have the powder. So we will put the powder at the end. So we're gonna put it on a high heat until the boil. And when it starts to boil, we're gonna reduce it a little bit. For a little simmer. I make the coffee now. I gave you that cup, John.
Okay.
Very gorgeous wife. Okay. So we're gonna wait for that. I have a coffee. Okay, so this is now boiling. So we're gonna reduce it, reduce the heat. For a very small simmer. So the milk, the rice is gonna pump all the milk and it's gonna be nice and soggy soggy. Okay, cool. Oh, my wife is there, amazing.
Okay. Cinnamon.
Thank you. I got some cinnamon stick. So we don't need to put the powder.
Hello.
Okay, let's put a cinnamon stick then, yeah? Okay, perfect. So we still leave it, huh? It's a very gentle simmer. Stir it time to time. Okay, so this, look, is cooked now. The rice is cooked. Yeah, it has a slight bite, but it's still quite liquidy, yeah? So that's good. Now I'm gonna increase the heat to evaporate all the rest of the liquid, yeah? And finish to cook what's left have to be cooked. Oh, it's amazing. I have the orange and cinnamon Tesla. It's really good. So I increase the heat, yeah? So it's burning a bit faster. And then we're gonna finish it with a little bit of butter. And I'm gonna try to put an egg yolk, which is gonna turn into a very custardy style, yeah? And because that's hot, it's just gonna pasteurize the yolks and cook it at the same time. So there is no risk of raw yolks or anything like that. It's like when you eat a carbonara pasta, you put the yolks just to combine everything together, which is cool. There. Then I like it quite runny, the rice pudding, so I'm not gonna reduce it totally. I think here is good enough. So look, see, when you do lala, it creates a line, but it gets covered in a bit, yeah, so it's quite juicy still, but that is gonna be pumped by the rice anyway. So now, out of the stove, we're just gonna put like around 20 grams of butter, just a little nut, yeah, little nut of butter. That's gonna help as well for the flavor and the shine. And I'm gonna put an egg yolk. There. Let's mix it through. Oh, this yolk is beautiful. Proper free range eggs, locally. Okay. That's done. So we're gonna plate it flat so it can cool down quickly. Up to the last drop. And now I think I'm gonna cling film it and let it cool down. And we come back to it once it's cold. So it's gonna steam and finish to pump the juice, yeah? So that's it. All right, so this has cooled down now. We're gonna remove the cling film. Maybe we're gonna just take that on the side. Up. So it's still a bit runny, it's how I like it, it's really good. If you want it less runny, you have to cook it a little bit more. Or to be honest, if you stay in the fridge for 24 hours, you will set even more than that. Let's try it a bit. This is cool. This is really nice. So, that's all, guys.